For the wild narrative with which I'm about to tell, I neither expect nor ask for belief. It would be mad to expect such a thing, in a case where my own senses reject their evidence. Yet I'm not mad, and I surely do not dream.
I suppose you're the young master the Mr. Aldwych waits for. Go ahead on in.
There you are. You haven't just come. But it's exceedingly dangerous to traverse the coast this time of day. I'm so glad you came. I find that the pleasant company of my relations calms my nerves. It's a pastime of mine. By keeping my mind occupied, I attempt to dispel some of the constitutional agitation which afflicts me.
What a delightful time that was.
Cousin, you've come. Oh, we're so happy.
Dear brother, delighted to see you. Please, join us.
Henry has just been relating his adventures to me. He's been everywhere.
But my travels are over. I'm ready to settle down.
Oh, you must say hello to Uncle Edwin. He's down on working in his studio. We worried about him. He is consumed by his paintings.
Out of the cellar. I said, keep out of the cellar.
Careful. I use as a special thinner. The fumes can do all sort of damage to you. A painter I knew fairly went mad from it. Poor soul. He scratched out his own eyes in a fit of frenzy. His own eyes! Just watch that you keep the windows open. You don't look well, my boy.
True. Nervous. Very, very dreadfully nervous I had been and am. But why do people say that I am mad? He's done me no harm. How has this idea entered my brain? It haunts me day and night. He's done me no harm.
You look as though you could use some hot soup.
Thank you.
It's grown late. Good night, young man.
Good night.
People fancy me mad. Madmen know nothing but me. I proceed with wisdom, with caution, with foresight. You'd have to be a very profound old man indeed to suspect that every night, just at 12, I look in on him while he sleeps. Stealthily. Stealthily. Closed. The eye is closed.
Good night. There.
I know that groan. It's the low sound that rises from the bottom of the soul when charged with mortal terror. Many at midnight it wells up from my own bosom, deepening with its dreadful echo the terrors that distract me. Yes, I know it well. Poor old man. He's been lying awake ever since that first noise, his fears growing, trying to fancy them causeless, but he cannot, because death
stalking with his black shadow before him as he enveloped the victim. What's that? My God. His heartbeat. He must be terrified. His heart will burst. Surely it will burst. What if a neighbor should hear it? There. No more. What's that? Hastily, but in silence, I dismembered the corpse. I cut off the head and the arms and the legs. There, all deposited neatly between the scantlings. Replaced so cunningly, no human eye, not even his, could detect anything wrong. Nothing to wash out, no blood spot whatever. All has been caught in a tub.
Sorry to disturb you, sir, but somebody or other heard a scream or some such. Called us up. We've got to check these things out.
What are you doing awake at this hour?
That'll do, Finlay.
Do come in, please, do.
Well, what about the scream, Sarge?
Oh, the scream, sir? What do you know about anything like that?
So that was I, Sergeant. I called out in a nightmare. I'm given to nervous fits.
A gentleman like yourself?
Well, what about the old man that lives here?
Finlay!
Gone to the country. Lucky man.
Might we be looking about a bit?
Of course, certainly. Search.
Check over there. The stove as well.
Yes, sir. Sir.
You'll want especially to look into the old man's room. Yes, look particularly here.
In here, boys.
Watch it.
Sorry.
Sit, sit. All of you, do.
Don't mind if I do. It's been a long day.
Of course, they don't suspect me. My manner has assuaged them. Indeed, they are delightful fellows. He keeps his treasure in the drawer there.
Oh, it's a lovely night, though. The stars are out in all their glory.
Hasn't been disturbed, sir.
Well, everything seems to be in order.
Don't go. No, stay. Stay a moment. Rest yourselves from your various fatigues. Ah, my head. And what is that annoying ringing in my ears? Will they never be gone? And that ringing. But wait. It's not in my ears. It's... my God. Can't they hear it? No. I'm safe. If only they'll leave. They must hear it. They must. And still. How is it they don't hear it? Cruel villains! Stop! Stop! I admit it! I confess! Tear up the planks! Here! Here! It is the beating of his hideous heart!
It must have been a dream. A dream dark and disturbing, a haunting dream. I was glad to find myself back in Edwin's silent home.